We love video games, and we're willing to spend a lot of money on them. In America alone, people spent over $43 billion on video games. No industry was as profitable as the gaming industry in the pandemic because, let's face it, no one was doing yoga sitting at home. Everyone was busy playing games. As one of the fastest growing sectors, the gaming industry is thriving. But what makes it so profitable and appealing? Today, we'll be exploring that question. But before we get into that, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe buttons. While some might still consider video games child's play, that couldn't be further from the truth. As gaming is the most expensive category in the entertainment industry, as people everywhere turn to gaming to connect, socialize, and play with their friends. According to data from Newzoo, players around the world spent more than $145 billion on computer, video, and mobile games in 2020, far exceeding global box office earnings and worldwide music venues, both of which stood at $42.5 billion and $20 billion, respectively. To talk about the gaming industry's profitability, we have to go back to the Dark Ages, in other words, the 90s, and look at the history of gaming. Although video game prototypes were created by scientists as early as in the 1950s, the very first gaming console was not introduced to consumers until the 70s. Subsequently, the use of online games began to proliferate in the 90s due to widespread internet adoption. Technology has largely influenced gaming. The late 1970s and early 1980s experienced an impressive boom in popularity of arcade games, bringing in serious commercial success. However, as revolutionary as those arcade games were, the gaming industry was facing a crisis. The market was being saturated, making sales and development suffer. The rise of PC gaming also made arcade games less interesting to many consumers. The internet became a whole thing, and the Nintendo Entertainment System established Nintendo literally as a household name. After the release of the Super Nintendo Entertainment System in 1990, it was all uphill from there. Then came the gaming consoles like Xbox, PlayStations, and other stuff people don't really know about. In 2020, Sony released what is still the best-selling console of all time, the PlayStation 2. Known as PS2, it sold over 150 million units. This console brought us hits like Final Fantasy X, Metal Gear Solid 2, Sons of Liberty, and Grand Theft Auto games. PC gaming became a huge sub. In 2003, online gaming rapidly gained popularity due to the increasing availability of the internet and digital storefront Steam launched, allowing gamers to buy and review games online. The last couple of years has seen the growth of a new trend: free-to-play online video games such as Fortnite and Apex Legends. Since it is completely free to register and play these games, one would think that the gaming industry isn't making much money off of them. But that isn't the case. Steve Jobs and Apple changed the world in many ways, intentionally and unintentionally. One of their creations, the App Store, has had the unintended action of revolutionizing the gaming industry. Apple's marketplace for apps encouraged rapid development and investment in the small industry, leading to a new wave of graphically impressive games. Monetization was a stumbling block for many developers, some of who came up with the savvy idea of introducing in-app purchases. Games like Candy Crush began posting impressive financial figures once their title introduced these purchases. In the following years, many companies and independent developers attempted to mimic the success of Candy Crush with their own free-to-download apps. Then, all of a sudden, the template found its way into video gaming through the immensely popular Battle Royale game, Fortnite. Millions of users rushed to download the game, and it soon became one of the most played video games in the world. Profitability came in the way of in-game purchases for character clothing, emotes, and other superficial details. For instance, out of Fortnite's $2.4 billion in revenue, over $1 billion was generated through the sale of in-game items. With this trend on the rise, most online games, including Call of Duty and FIFA, are now shifting to the free-to-play model with a focus on thousands of dollars that get traded through in-game items. Advertisements also played a role in the profitability of these games. Mobile is the largest gaming platform, producing $68.5 billion in revenue in 2019, 45% of the total market, including PC and tablet gaming. Although still a relatively new segment of the industry, mobile gaming has developed at an astonishing rate, with 2.4 billion people playing games on mobile in 2020. Mobile game developers have enjoyed a lot of success in the last few years. Although mobile gaming has caused the death of handheld gaming devices, consoles are still booming, and each new generation of consoles welcomes a new era of technology and capabilities. Two industries that could well play a key role in the future of gaming are virtual reality and artificial intelligence technology. With industry leaders such as Oculus and Valve announcing cheaper headset options, blurring the lines between fantasy and reality is becoming more accessible for mass markets, and the pace could pick up further in 2022. Cloud gaming is another new technology that takes advantage of faster, more reliable internet connections by giving gamers the ability to stream games rather than playing on a console. All this creates a new opportunity for the industry to massively profit from the ever-growing business and technology. Even players can make quite some cash by live streaming and growing their business. If you want to know how much games actually make, an analyst interviewed by MarketWatch claims GTA 5 has made more than $6 billion, more than any single media title in history. For perspective, James Cameron's Avatar, the highest-grossing movie in history, grossed $2.8 billion. League of Legends makes $1.6 billion annually, and even Candy Crush made almost $1 billion in 1 year. But you're probably not going to have such high-end games in your basement. It takes millions of dollars to develop a single game. However, you can still profit from the gaming industry by playing video games. Gaming is considered a new type of business that could earn you some cash. However, note that before you can earn from gaming, you will need to invest in yourself as a gamer and equipment. If you didn't know yet, gaming could be an expensive business to start because of the stuff you need to start the business. Gaming computers, cameras, games, even gaming chairs. Though there are games that are free to play, you will likely need to get the paid versions if you really want to open this kind of business and earn money. Ask yourself what you are good at, whether you have the right equipment, and if you can commit yourself to do this business. Gaming can also be very time-consuming. If you're planning on vlogging or making a video production company, you should at least know a couple of tricks and be an expert in a particular game. Once your channel is monetized, you can start streaming or posting videos to earn money. You'll also need to grow your channel and have more followers to get you on track to earning. The more followers and viewers, the more likely you'll earn. In the coming months, Google Stadia and Apple Arcade are expected to be released to the masses. The new cloud-based gaming servers are set to further revolutionize the gaming world, allowing players to access a wide range of titles through a subscription model. This will open more doors and opportunities for people who love gaming. Soon, people will be able to play without consoles and just a remote. All these developments in the fast-growing gaming industry are very exciting. Whichever model you choose, do look back fondly on the video game history timeline and be grateful that Pac-Man had to walk so the whole video gaming industry could run. That's it for today, folks. I hope you enjoyed it. Let us know in the comments what you think about the new modes of gaming. Also, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel.